story this week about David. Do you remember David from last week? He was the shepherd's boy and God made him king, and he danced and praised God at the front of a procession as they carried the Ark of the Covenant into Jerusalem. Well, today's story is going to tell you a wee bit more about David. So this is David, and God took him from being somebody, a shepherd boy, these are the sheep that he looked after, and God told him that he was going to be king. So here's David as king. Okay, you can see his crown on his head. Now, David lived in a lovely palace, so it was maybe something like this. It had brick walls, just like the houses we lived in, but it was very ornate and very decorated. But David knew that God's Ark of the Covenant lived in a tent. Now, if you can remember about the Ark of the Covenant, we've talked about it for the last few weeks. It was a box and it symbolised God's presence with the Israelites, and it lived in a tent. So one day David had an idea. So here's David having an idea, and the idea is the exclamation mark coming out of his head. And he decided that he should build God a palace. Or maybe not a palace, it was maybe more of a temple where the Ark of the Covenant should stay. So he didn't want the Ark of the Covenant to stay in the tent anymore, in the tent like this. He wanted to build it a beautiful building, a temple. But God didn't agree. God said no. He didn't like David's idea. He said that he was happy with the Ark of the Covenant living in the temple. But God also told David something else. He said that there will always be a king in his family. So here's David wearing a king, and God told him, or wearing a crown, I should say, and God told him that he would have lots of children, but there would always be a king in his family and his descendants. So David had children, and his children had children, and his children had children, and so on. And there was always going to be a king and his descendants. So here's a wee picture of David's descendants. So they're all wearing a crown. And David's son was called Solomon, and he became king. So this is Solomon. And it was Solomon instead of David that built a beautiful building for the Ark of the Covenant to live in. But years later, David, one of David's descendants who wore a crown, came back, and he was the one that called himself the Good Shepherd. So if you remember that David looked after sheep, but this person called himself the Good Shepherd, and there was also shepherds came to visit him when he was born. So I wonder if you can think who that could be. Yes, it was Jesus. So this is a picture of what Jesus may have looked like. Jesus was one of David's descendants, one of David's descendants who would be king, but Jesus is a very special king. He's the one that will be king forever. So here's a picture of a crown, and it says underneath it, King Forever. And that King Forever is Jesus. And Jesus is our king, and he's our Lord. And it just means that he's the one that made everything. Jesus made the whole world. He made all the plants and all the animals and the sea and everything that you can see. And he made you, and he made me. And as well as making everything, Jesus will be with us always. And he told us that one day at the end of Matthew, it says, "And lo, I am with you always." So David was king for a wee while. Then all his descendants, there was always a king in his family. And the last one of these was Jesus. And we need to remember that Jesus is with us forever, because Jesus is the King forever. So in the story, we talked about the Ark of the Covenant, and that symbolized God's presence with the Israelites. So that reminded the Israelites that God was always with them. We don't have a reminder like that today, but we know that Jesus is with us forever, and we can talk to him at all times. Thank you. Let us pray. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for the birds and the animals, the flowers and the trees, the lakes and the streams, and the sun that rises and sets over them each day. Thank you for creating everything we see. Thank you for the life we live and for making each person different. Thank you for Jesus, who died for us so that we can go to heaven one day just for believing in him. What an amazing God you are. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, for our craft this week, I just want you to look at this picture. Now, this is a picture of the Ark of the Covenant. So it's just like a box with poles on either side of it. And on the top, there's two cherubim. And cherubim are just a bit like angels. So I would like you to try to draw an Ark of the Covenant. And once you have it drawn, just keep it beside your bed or somewhere that you can look at it. And let it remind you that God was always with the Israelites. That box symbolised God's presence with them. And he is always with us because Jesus has said that he'll always be with us. So if you can draw something like that, the pictures will come up again at the end for you to copy. And this is something that we have in the house that somebody made a drawing, and you maybe can't see the writing very well, but it says on it, "Lo, I am with you always." Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. And that's what Jesus said, and it was just to remind us that we are never alone, that Jesus is always with us. So you could draw something like that. It doesn't have to be your the letter R, but it could be maybe the first letter of your name. You could copy it and draw it out and then put on it Matthew 28 verse 20. "Lo, I am with you always," so you remember that Jesus is always with you. Okay, so that's all for this week, and we'll see you all next week.